Alrighty then, we are here. Let's make that capture card visible. There we go. So I want to see if I can... Okay, moon presence, can you chill out? Is the music okay? It's not too loud or anything? That should be fine. Okay, so what we are doing here is, we're gonna finish Shadow of the Colossus and go from there, really. Open up live split. Aw, man. Alright, we're not going to be able to have a live split running because I hoped that it would save the time that it was currently at, but it does not, so we're just going to hop right in. Not that we need it, it was just fun to have up. I don't think it counts cutscenes though, so we're just going to jump in, and yeah, we're finishing... Shadow of the Colossus. And then if I have time, we're gonna do, the guy in the lake. Yeah. I know he's coming soon.
Yeah.
But yeah, we're gonna do that, and then, yeah, chemical plant, baby. What are you doing? I hate this horse. Yeah. Started Tears of the Kingdom. I rode a horse for like 5 minutes. Not even. It is so much better. I even thought to myself, it's going to be... thank God we're almost done with Shadow of the Colossus, because it's going to be impossible to go back after this shit. God, this sucks. Ocarina of Time came out like 25 years ago, and that shit was more responsive than this. Alright, yeah, I think it is the lake guy. Hey, Aiden, how's it hanging? Good to hear from you. I do still have the settings. Sometimes the settings at the top and sometimes it's at the bottom. Okay, good, I do have the music on. Just so we can listen to different music than the same boss theme over and over and over again. My day's alright. You know, just kind of been hanging out.
Yeah.
Hoping to finish this game.
Yeah.
It'll be a hell of a lot better once I finish this game. Although, I planned that if we finish this early enough, we'll just go play some more Desolate Hope, and I still gotta look up a good strategy for that game, because it is difficult. Not difficult, but just very obtuse. You know, I wanted to like Desolate Hope, but it's just like, it's like four different games stacked on top of each other instead of just one game with a bunch of mechanics that work together. But, you know, maybe I'll get good at it. Maybe I'll become a real... Oh my god. That was extremely scary. Maybe I'll just need to get that no death trophy. No. This happened to us on our last playthrough. Come on, so. Oh, we're good. We got this. Gotta get around the waterfall. Alright, now we're pretty safe. Okay, yeah, we got this. But yeah, so we're just, I'm hoping to finish this. I'm hoping it doesn't take more than, like, another, like, I hope we can do, let's talk anime. Okay, dude, what do you got for me? If it's not JoJo, I don't really know anything about it, I'm gonna be honest. No secret that I love JoJo. Literally, my follower notification is literally Star Platinum. Dude, stop, so I can climb you. There we go. Audio levels are off or anything. You know, it's hard to know if I'm doing everything right and everything, you know. Alright, no spoilers. Hey, I think that, you know, if we're talking about part one, I think it's very good. Everyone shits on Phantom Blood. They're like, oh, it's the worst part, it's bad. It's like, it is not the best of the series, but it's not bad. And I think that people who say it's better don't. Like, it's a simple story, you know? It's allowed to not be super complex. like, oh, there's no stand. It's just Hamon. Okay, and? Hamon's a good power system if you aren't a weirdo. If you aren't a loser. Yes, stands are better, but, like, I still like Hamon. Which then, you know, people criticize the other parts for just totally getting rid of Hamon. And it's like, well... It's different. This is a light spoiler, but it's not... It doesn't really matter at all. Like, after part two, Hamon is really not a thing that they deal with. It switches right over to stands, which if you've heard of JoJo, you know what stands are. And yeah, stands are much more creative and much more cool, but Hamon, they do everything interesting that there is to do with it, and then they move on. And that's... You know, and stands are like a... Imagine a person with asthma that tries to use Hamon. Yeah, that's probably a little difficult. The thing with that, though, the thing with Hamon is that it's just... You could probably use Hamon to... Really, dude. You could probably use some kind of Hamon thing to... cure asthma. That's probably possible. I mean, Zapelli uses it to heal all of Jonathan's wounds from the fire. And they, it technically doesn't heal him, I don't think. It just helps the body heal it. But I'm pretty sure Hamon can just, like, heal shit. I wonder what actual speedruns of this game look like. Yeah. Like, I wonder if... I assume it's not taking advantage of a lot of glitches. It's mainly just, like, what we do with Colossus 2, where we... Instead of... actually riding the horse down, you just hop in front of the, like, entrance and the rocks up there and then jump down. And I'm sure it's a lot of skips like that. I'm gonna be like free there. Yeah, it's just like... Hamon is very much just like a... I mean, a lot of anime and a lot of... Yeah, like a lot of anime and manga like to have like shit like ki, like martial arts type shit. That's really what Hamon is, you know? That is... It is a supernatural martial arts thing, you know? It's all about controlling your breathing and letting energy flow through you. And again, it's cool, it's unique, but it runs its course. Yeah. then you switch over to stands, which are, like, limited only by your imagination. There's... You can do anything you can think of with stands. Back to me. I'm a little stuck.
Oh god!
Oh, we're good, we're good, we're good. Okay. You first. Way he doesn't go underground. Because if you try to get more than one in one go, he goes underground. So I think if we... Oh, we hit that. Wow. So I think the best way to do it is to get the first one, let yourself fall, and then get back up and hit the second two. Because after you get the second one, you should have enough time before he goes underground to get the pick. Hopefully. We'll find out. I don't know why I'm having such a hard time climbing up. I usually... Oh my god. I don't have such a problem. I'm climbing the wings. Oh boy, screen shave. That's so cool. I love getting my brand. There we go. Yeah, that's what I was saying, you know. Because of how... I think that it's less about the fact that Hominid focuses on breath, but just because of how terrible smoking is for your body. Assuming we're talking about cigarettes. Don't smoke, kiddos. You know, with how bad, like, cigarettes are for your body... your body just is weaker. So yeah, I would say definitely it would make being a Hamon master harder. But, you know, again, once we get to stands, there are plenty of stand users who you see smoking, so... a couple of them are literally some of the most powerful stands in the series. Dragon Driftway? Dragon Palace. I'm so happy that they changed the battle mode in Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. It's so much better. I don't know, you know, I know no one owned a Wii U, so no one played the original Mario Kart 8, but holy crap, the original battle mode in that game is ass. Worst in the entire series. Literally, that was the only thing that they needed to change for 8 Deluxe, and it is the now my favorite game in the series. And they did, you know, they did change it. Instead of the stupid, like, reverse track shit, they just made a regular battle mode like the rest of the series. Don't use Hammond. Well, again, no spoilers, but there are.
Yeah! Yeah!
Which, again, I could explain how all that works, but it would require me to go into spoilers. The relationship between Hammond and Stans, and basically all I'll say is the original Japanese name or something for Stans was Yuhamon. So it literally has Hammond in the name. So yeah, we can cut through this arena. Why not? So they are connected, sort of, but that's kind of a dropped point in the lore. Which makes the Switch make a little more sense. But yeah, you do see Hamon users who also have Stans. It's pretty cool. I hope this actually leads to the boss arena and I don't have to, like, go around in some roundabout way like an idiot. And how many more are there? That was, what, 12, 13, 14? This is 14, I believe. Then it's just the wall guy and, it's the lion, the wall guy, and... Alright, thanks for stopping by while you could, Aiden. I very much appreciate it. Have a good one. There being anyone else to fight, so I have to assume that this is it.
Yeah!
I'm gonna hopefully... I'll remember to, after I beat this, to delete a bunch of the extra saves off of my system, so I'm not my PlayStation 5 isn't filled with like using a bunch of memory for save files and extra save files in this game. Because after I finish this playthrough, I don't need them. Not that it's a large amount, it's just like, I don't like that it's wasted on something I'm never going to use ever again. The game is short enough that if for whatever reason I need to replay a boss fight or something, maybe I need footage for a video or something, I'll just re-download it and get to the boss. It's like the game, if you know what you're doing and you're speedrunning it, it's like 2 hours long. If I need it that bad, I can just do it myself. Twilight Princess, what? Cave. Okay, nice. I assume this is like the caves you can find. Because, yeah, I think there are like caves underground or something, like an Ocarina of Time. I don't remember. I think they are in the Wii U version. That's how you get a lot of like the stamps and shit that you can use on Miiverse. Which, if when we eventually do play Twilight Princess, I will make sure that it is PhD. Praying that by then they port it to the Switch, which is unlikely. So. Oh yeah. And it's nice because, like, on its own, it just feels very calming and just chill. It's got a very nice vibe to it. But, like, if it was paired with some, like, creepy, like, cave, it would be creepy. But if you just, it's just, like, a nice little serene area. Like, I assume it's used in, it would just be like, very chill and calm. For some reason, I'm like, oh, I wonder if it'll deal damage. And then after it never dealt damage, it didn't occur to me to just switch back. Never occurred to me to do that on my last playthrough, or even earlier on this one. So you can just use the glider, or not glider, the parachute. Got that Fortnite brain rot. You have to get him to knock this one down because it knocks the wall over. Thank you. Am I dead? Did I die in a cutscene? Okay, good. Loser, get your ass over here. Stop turning the camera and let me play. That's the way the game actually wants you to do it. But then, in the cutscene, you're like 20 feet away. So, what? Well, boss is over, so cool music is done. Yeah! Comet Observatory, baby! Alright, I'm done. It's good. It's a good song. Alright, I already know where this... It's two more dudes. One is up this way, and one is the other way. I wonder what I'm gonna do next. I'm thinking Code Veronica X, the next Resident Evil game. so many Twilight Princess songs today. I mean, we usually do just because there's a lot of them on here, but like this feels like a lot. I was hoping to do this yesterday, but I got my schedule at work mixed up, so I thought I had to work in the morning, and it turns out I had to go in the afternoon. I just didn't have a chance to stream, or else we would have already finished this by now. It is what it is. I'll live. We're doing it now. I love this sword. It's such a well-designed sword. You know, you got the nice shape, the handle's very cool, the runes are cool, the fact that it is, like, lit up with, like, electricity is awesome. What? That wasn't even where his foot was. I mean, alright, it was. But, like, come on, man. Alright, well, that one worked. Jazz over here, boy. honestly just not in the mood for it. I'm not vibing with it. Okay. That's mainly so that we have a good area to jump down. That's why I don't need to know where all of his spots are. Heart, I think there's one on his back. No, there's the one on his back. Lord of the Castle's just awesome, period, but... Get up to the arm.
Already known, Kaido. You alone can do Hazel. Mother's the one who could.
Nah, that ain't happening. Unless I can, like.
Thank you.
we go. That was close. Thank you, guy. Cranky as hog. Oh no, that's a car. That's a different guy. Oh, yo, first try? There we go. Got him. Alright. Okay. Last one is directed to the south. Another good song this time. Oh, this is good as hell. You know, a lot of these like MIDI recreations of songs and the sound font of other games, they have a tendency to just not sound good. Sometimes they're really good though. Like, I found this guy this morning who made a couple Korn songs in the Ocarina of Time sound font. It sounds so good. This part is really good. That's nice that you can do it while you're on Argo. Pray here, so we have it unlocked, and then I'm going to make a save. I love that gaha at the end. This cutscene is terrible. There's no reason for it. Bro doesn't want to go up because he knows he's about to die on this bridge. Even though he doesn't die, spoiler alert. Ribbon Road, okay. This sounds so familiar. Yeah, it's because I play on Ribbon Road all the time. It's an awesome track. Hopefully it'll let us use Cloak of Deception. And just run past. Looks like. Hmm. Okay, Bloodborne music, that's fitting. It often is. It's kind of hard to see ourselves. Could have been really bad. And here we go, moment of truth. If we can get past this part, food for thought, I guess. God, let me up. It's such bullshit for no reason. Just switch the song right at the perfect moment. Got him. Perfectly programmed. Really? You can't skip this? Yeah, take me back. Take me back. Skip to a different room. And we can't skip this. So we're sitting and waiting then. Hopefully this all goes well. So, yeah, this is nice that we're finally finished with this game. Hopefully. There's no reason that we can't skip this. Like, we very much should be able to. It's very odd that we can't. It's just so weird that you have to sit through the entire credits every time. It's so boring, honestly. Especially since we have to wait to know if we did the trophy correctly. Probably gonna after this is over, if assuming that we got both of the trophies, I'm probably gonna take a short break. Maybe not short, but like, you know, yeah, it'll actually probably be longer. And then I'll be back in a little bit to play some to hopefully play a decent chunk of the Desolate Hope. We'll see though. YouTube Music decided it doesn't want to work now. YouTube Music shits the bed again at the most random time possible. I can't do anything, bro. I can't. As we'll continue to exist in these sealed lands. Okay, but what about the girl? She didn't do shit. That's just weird. That's weird that they did that. That they put the baby in. That's just odd. You know what I mean? Like, it's just weird. Alright, here we go. I'm gonna have this back. And you know what? This is not a bad game. I want to make that clear.
I don't need this game.
It's just, like, the trophies are annoying to get. Some of the bosses are poorly designed. Most of them are good. Or fine. I just don't think that the gameplay stands the test of time. Like, it's just not... It's not bad. It just isn't great, and it's kind of overrated. The ending is weird. With the baby. I don't like that. Is that him? Reborn? Is the baby Dorman? Like, you could have just had the same ending, but with just the girl and the horse. Maybe you could have had him, like, I don't know what else. Deer walk like that. And it's also just weird that all these animals just live here and are completely fine. Like, we've seen the birds, but it's like, why are there, like... Yeah, we've seen the doves and the falcons, but, like, what's with the deer living in this little tiny garden and the squirrels? Weird. Like, I don't hate the simplicity of it, and I don't hate that a lot of it is vague and just kind of weird, but, like, I don't know.
Some of it just doesn't make any sense.
I mean, I get that it's, like, that it's supposed to be, like, a legendary, like, myth or whatever with the hero killing the monsters and turning in to the monster to save the girl. Like, but, like, in his selfishness, he wasn't able to then be with the girl, and I don't know. I get it. It's just, I don't know. I'm not crazy about it. We got Speed Demon. We got Last Man Standing. And you know what that means. The Horned Boy. That's our platinum, baby. What is our time? What was our time at?
Just under 2 hours.
I got a bunch of games on PlayStation Plus. I went to download them just so they would be saved in my, like, list. That's why. So I'd remember that they're there and that I want to play them at some point. But yeah. There we go. That's awesome. We did it. We did it, Reddit. That was Shadow of the Colossus. It's a fine game. Again, not bad at all. Just wonder how. What? I wonder what percentage of people have gotten the platinum. 1%. We're in the top 1% of Shadow of the Colossus players. Wow. That is a feat that I do not take lightly. God. Where did we start this game? Beginning of April. Took us a while. Hopefully Code Veronica X won't be as long. I'm not gonna start it tonight, but we're gonna get back to Planets of Freddy's. So yeah, stream's gonna go offline for a little bit. I don't know how long for sure, but I will be back soon. And I'll post on Twitter or whatever. You guys will get a notification, you know how it is. But yeah, so see you in a minute. If you're leaving or if you're watching the VOD, have a good night. Take care of yourselves, drink lots of water, and please, as always, have yourselves a damn good one. Peace out.